Red Notice. This is a movie starring Dwayne Johnson, Ryan Reynolds, and Gal Gadot. After an FBI profiler, played by Dwayne Johnson, is framed for a crime he did not commit, he is forced to work with a famous art thief, played by Ryan Reynolds, in an attempt to steal Cleopatra's famous third egg, which is a big artifact, apparently. I don't know if that is a real thing. I know very little about the art community. Red Notice should win an Academy Award, but sadly it will not, because the award that it should win is for a category that does not exist, and that's because Red Notice is the stupidest movie of 2021. I could make an entire two-hour video deconstructing every dumb thing that happens in this film. There are lapses in logic, there are plot holes, there are conveniences and contrivances aplenty. The narrative in this movie makes Michael Bay look like Alfred Hitchcock, and yet, I liked it. I enjoy this movie, and I am so stunned, because this is totally the kind of movie that I would come on here typically and completely skewer, and yet there's something about it that just endeared me, and by the end of it, I found myself actually legitimately enjoying it. The biggest reason this thing works for me, and I feel like this is becoming kind of a running theme throughout my channel, is I just think Ryan Reynolds is like the funniest actor in Hollywood. He consistently makes me laugh more than any other actor working right now. I feel like he's comedically stuck out of time. I've heard people compare him to Chevy Chase, and while he's not the brilliant physical comedian that Chevy Chase was, I think when you look at his ability to improvise and his charisma, I do feel like that is an apt comparison. For a guy who I don't believe came up as a comedian, he has a very high batting average when it comes to his improv, and he has some lines in this movie that legitimately made me laugh out loud. I mean, there are movies that people find hilarious. James Gunn's The Suicide Squad, which everybody said, oh my God, it's the funniest movie I've ever seen, didn't make me laugh, and yet Ryan Reynolds multiple times throughout this movie just had a one-liner that made me laugh pretty hard. I think his chemistry with Dwayne Johnson in this is really, really good too. I mean, I think that one of the reasons why The Rock is arguably the biggest movie star in the world right now is because he has the ability to have good chemistry with anybody that he works with, and him and Ryan Reynolds bounce off of each other really, really well. This movie feels like kind of a throwback. It's an adventure movie. It's a heist movie. It's a globetrotting adventure. I will have to check, but I don't believe it's based on a pre-established property. I don't believe it's, I know it's not a sequel. I don't think it's based on a comic book. And there's something about that that I found charming and kind of simplistic. And in 2021, for a movie like that to exist and have the budget it does, I found pretty cool. This movie is directed and written by Rawson Marshall Thurber. He's known for comedy. He directed Dodgeball, We're the Millers, and Central Intelligence, which also starred Dwayne Johnson. I've always felt like he's had a very good feel for how comedy works. When you have a really talented comedic actor like Ryan Reynolds, I feel like it would be very easy to fall into the trap that so many like Melissa McCarthy movies have fallen into over the last several years or so, which is you have a very talented actor, let's just turn on the camera and let them improvise and never say cut. Here, I felt like they did a good job of moving at a good clip. They cut out probably what was a lot of the not so funny stuff, and they kept in the stuff that did work. And I think that's the result of having a director who has a very good understanding of comedy. This movie is almost 2 hours long, and yet I found myself interested in every single scene. It's not engaging necessarily. I wasn't on the edge of my seat just dying to see what was going to happen next, but it moved at a good pace. And when it ended, I'm like, oh, okay, I'm kind of glad I watched that. I enjoyed that. I think I enjoy this movie. I think when we get to the end of this review, I believe I'm going to give this a positive rating. I can't sit here and act like it's a good movie. Like I said at the beginning, this thing is completely stupid. I mean, the action is nonsensical. There's so many double and triple crosses and so many silly twists, and I guarantee you that most of them probably don't make sense. Rawson Marshall Thurber, like I said, is known for being a comedic director. He wrote and directed this, and that really shines through, because this is an action comedy, and I felt like the action in it is pretty lame. There's a lot of kind of just so stunts, a lot of bad CGI, a lot of bad green screen. And for a movie that, like I said, I think moves at a very good clip, when I was watching the action sequences, I just remember feeling like, okay, I'm just kind of waiting for this to end, because I want to get back to the improv. I want to get back to kind of the one-liners and the back and forth between Dwayne Johnson and Ryan Reynolds, because it is genuinely funny and endearing. But the action itself really does not work. I've criticized Gal Gadot on this channel in the past. I criticized her performance in Wonder Woman 1984. I criticized her performance in Zack Snyder's Justice League. And while she is better in this, I will say that when you have two actors who are as likable as Dwayne Johnson and Ryan Reynolds are, it often feels like she's kind of third wheeling this entire thing. She's not awful, but I feel like you could have had an actress with more charisma, like an Ana de Armas or a Margot Robbie, somebody who has the ability to match these two comedically. I understand that she is the straighter edged of the three characters in this. And like I said, she's okay, but I feel like by comparison, she's not as good as the other two who are really game for this entire project. I know I've said this multiple times, but it can't be overstated just how dumb this movie is. I mean, it's not even remotely plausible, which would be okay. Some of my favorite movies are action movies with single-digit IQs. I mean, I love the Schwarzenegger catalog from the 80s, movies like Predator and Commando, which are so stupid, but I feel like the difference between those movies and this is that those movies had directors that kind of set their own ground rules.
You son of a bitch. What's the matter? The CIA got you pushing too many pencils?
Here, even within the realm of the universe that this film creates, it jumps the shark multiple times. I completely understand why this movie is not getting a positive reception from critics. I mean, we're approaching Oscar season right now, and you have a movie that kind of feels like it's the equivalent of a pig rolling around in mud for 2 hours, and yet, you know what? That can be charming, depending on the circumstances, and I'm shocked. I really am shocked, because as much as I like Ryan Reynolds, and as much as I like The Rock, I kept waiting for the moment where I was going to turn on this movie, and I never really did. I'm stunned. I'm giving this a 6 out of 10. I recommend it. And don't see it in theaters, and I don't even know if it is in theaters. It's on Netflix right now, where you can watch it for free, quote-unquote. And, if you have a weekend afternoon and all your football teams are done playing, give this a watch. I legitimately found it, endearing and funny and enjoyable. I don't love it. It's only a 6, but it is, one of the bigger surprises of the year. So, yeah, that'll do it for this review. Hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Let's get those watch hours up, up, up. We are so close. We are painfully close to 2,000 subs, so let's get there. You can follow me on Twitter, at Castellani2014. Thank you very much for watching this review and all the reviews that I've been putting out. Everybody, have a great rest of your day. Peace and happiness.